Thank you for dropping by my channel. My name is Angela Tauscher and I'm broker owner at Rover Realty in Mesa, Arizona. Now, if you watched the previous episode, you'll know that I moved here from the Pacific Northwest about 15 years ago. And my goal with this channel is to share the good, the bad, and the ugly about moving to Arizona. Now, if you already live here, stay tuned. I am always shocked by how many people that have lived here for decades that don't know really important stuff about Arizona and the home they live in or the area they live in. One example, case in point, I did a short video a few days ago about our post-tension slabs here. Within 24 hours, I had 10,000 views and comments from people who had no idea that you can't cut into our post-tension slabs. For example, where I'm from, it's very common that you put a safe in the ground and then you cover and hide it with a little piece of carpet or something. Can't do that here. Or if you're going to do that, you better have a professional helping you, because when that post-tension gets cut into, it releases these rods that go flying through the house that can actually kill you. Now, we don't want any of that to happen to you. So be sure to hit the subscribe button, the little red bell, so that when I do new videos, it's a little nerve-wracking, but I'm gonna do it every single week. I can share with you things to avoid and things to look for, whether you already live here in Arizona or you'll be moving here. So let's get right into it. Today, we are going to talk about schools in Arizona. I know, if you have Googled anything about the education system in Arizona, you'll probably see that we come up 48th overall for worst schools in the United States. Now, hang tight, stay with me. My own children have gone through the entire school system in Arizona and they survived. They're doing great. There's a few different options that I'm going to tell you about today, so let's get to it. First and foremost, we have our public schools, we have charter schools. I had no idea what that was when I moved here. And then of course we have private schools. Most people have heard of private schools. Okay, let's start with our public schools. Now, our public schools are funded by the state. They're open to just about everybody. And you'll find that classroom sizes are a little bit larger. They tend to have anywhere from 21 to 25 students in the typical classroom for kindergarten through 12th grade. Public schools also tend to have busing available if you live in Boundary. I'll talk about boundaries a little bit later, but I wanna move on to charter schools. Now, when I moved here, as I mentioned before, I had no idea what a charter school was. I thought it meant it was a private school, and I was completely wrong. Charter schools are also funded by the state. However, they have private operations. And so what that means is they tend to be able to have a lot more control over their curriculum, over their staffing. They tend to be much smaller class sizes, but they're free to the public, to anybody that's eligible for the charter schools. They are a phenomenal option. Now, one of the differences with the charter schools is there's typically no busing available. So you have to figure out carpooling with, you know, other parents or plan for that drop-off pickup every day. And the second thing is they often have some sort of requirement for a variety of a school uniform, but overall they are a really great choice here in Arizona if you are just not on board with the public school. Now my kids, they have done both public and charter, and we've seen good things and bad things in both situations. Now the third option we have in Arizona are private schools. Private schools are not publicly funded, and so if you're thinking what I'm thinking, yes, they are expensive. You will typically see our private schools in Arizona run anywhere from $10,000 to $14,000 a year per student, which of course is paid for by their parents. So there are a few other surprises about our school systems in Arizona. If you saw me laughing at myself in the prior video, I mentioned how my kids actually missed their first week of school because I had no idea that most Arizona schools are what we call year-round school. So that means we actually typically start school here in July, or worst case, sometimes early August. And year-round school has some a unique setup. Children have a fall break for 2 weeks typically, and then they have their normal winter break, and then we usually have a two-week spring break, and then again summer break. The summer break's just shortened. Now there's a variety of different combinations of that amongst our schools here, but that is a very common one. Where I moved from in the Pacific Northwest, we didn't typically start school until after Labor Day in September. So I had no idea to even think to look that my kids might be missing school. So that is one thing to plan and prepare for if you're thinking about moving here to Arizona. Now, as I mentioned before, our public schools do have boundaries, and those boundaries boundaries can be a little wonky. Let me give you an example. When we first moved here, we lived in Queen Creek, Arizona, but our kids were assigned to Higley School District. Higley is another city, but the school they actually went to was in Gilbert, Arizona. So we lived in Queen Creek, assigned to Higley School District, but the school was actually in Gilbert. And that is really common here. The boundaries just are all wonky all through the various cities. It's very challenging to figure out online what school district are you actually in. And I can tell you as a realtor, I've been asked many times before to set up a search, you know, that I only want my kids to be in the Chandler School District. Well, that is very challenging to do. We actually have to just pick an area and make a lot of phone calls to figure out if the home that you like falls in that school district. But the good news is it's very common here to get a boundary exception. Matter of fact, I don't know many parents that their kids are actually in the right boundary. That's how often it happens that you just get a boundary exception. Now, of course, you only have to worry about the boundaries for your public schools. Charter schools, typically no boundaries. You just have to keep in mind that you'll be responsible for getting your students to the school both before and after school. And that's why many parents will set up a carpool system. Another pleasant surprise when we moved here was the kindergarten system. My youngest was just about to enter into kindergarten, and in the Pacific Northwest, kindergarten's typically a half day, and sometimes the school will have an option that they can do a full day, but the parents are pretty much going to pay for that. It's not typically free. Here in Arizona, there is an option for half day or full day kindergarten, but the great part is it is typically free if you want to do the full day kindergarten program. Another perk that we have here is we do have a state credit dollar for dollar tax that's available to parents. It's actually available to everybody, and those funds can be used for stuff that you're already paying for your students, like extracurricular fees, field trips, any special projects. Of course, you have to make sure it's eligible, but it is a wonderful dollar for dollar program that has a maximum limit, of course, that's available to us Arizona residents. Now, if none of those options work for you, you know, the public, the charter, the private, we do have a lot of online programs for our students here in Arizona as well. As a matter of fact, during COVID, we ended up enrolling our youngest in the Chandler Online Academy, which thankfully had actually been established for well over a decade. It was a very smooth, well-oiled transition and process, and our kid actually liked it so much that he stayed on one more year and graduated from high school in that program. Another great perk for our Arizona graduates is there's a couple scholarship opportunities that are pretty standardized. As long as they meet GPA requirements and they graduate from an Arizona high school after attending 9th through 12th grade, that are just pretty much given to the kids. One of those examples is when they meet the eligibility requirements that they get 2 years free at certain community colleges, which is a great start for some kids that aren't maybe ready to take the big leap into a university. A second opportunity that our children all utilized was the Lumberjack Scholarship, and that is for NAU, which is Northern Arizona University. And if they got a 3.5 or higher GPA all 4 years of high school, they got this free four-year ride to NAU that covered all of their tuition. The only thing we were responsible was their books and boarding expenses. So that was a phenomenal scholarship for all three of our kids. So whether you're moving here in 9 days or 9 months, be sure to like, comment, subscribe. I want to know, what is it you're curious about in Arizona? What can I share with you? And if you already live here, I know I'm still sharing something that you can tell others that was new to you as well. My next video I'll be doing on critters, you know, all the things about Arizona that people tend to get kind of scared about. So be sure to hit the like, subscribe, follow, because there are so many ways to deal with our critters, and a lot of times it's so overblown. It's not what you think it is. We still want you. Come on down to Arizona. Check it out. It's a beautiful place to experience and a beautiful place to live.